How's it going, Jeremiah? This is the PSR-SX700, which I have had the opportunity of playing quite a number of hours every single day on it, as well as teaching my students on this PSR-SX700. And I have jotted down a lot of my thoughts on my notebook, and today I'm here to share with you what I think about this latest keyboard arranger from Yamaha. There are 12 things I love about this PSR-SX700 and 11 things I'm just not too hot about, and that came from my extensive playing on this instrument for the past couple of weeks. I have also come to 3 conclusions about this keyboard, so make sure you stay tuned right to the end. Do check out the links in my description where I have my list of recommended digital pianos and arranger keyboards for players and students of all levels. The first thing that strikes you when you are seeing this keyboard for the first time is that it feels premium. It doesn't feel cheap at all, and that's a good sign, especially for the kind of price you are paying. And previous owners of the PSR S series keyboard, especially the PSR S770, 775, PSR S970, 975, you can rejoice because the really irritating and unnatural bass thumping sound is gone from the system. Finally, this has a lot better and natural sound. You know, the previous models, I just had to EQ out that unnaturally thumping bass, which not just me, you know, but if you go check out in the forums, a lot of people had complained about that. Next, let's talk about the keybit. This keybit has been significantly improved over that of the PSR S series, so it is a lot less noisy and it offers a greater resistance. However, it is nowhere near that found on the Genos, and it is now very comparable to that found on the Korg PA700, which is very similarly priced to this. The fourth thing I love about the PSR-SX700 is right out of the box, every sound, every style has been tuned to be sweet to the listener's ears. So there isn't really very much tweaking to be done if you're trying to cater to the ears of the mass market. And this is quite a big difference from that of the Korg PA series, because the Korg PA series is actually technically superior to this SX series. Let's not try to cover it up. It is technically more superior. However, you need to tweak it a lot. You need to put in the work, and it also has more features for you to bring out yet little nuance of a sound. So if you want something out of the box, ready to use, that sounds good, this is the one. If you want to have something which is deeper, more superior, more complex, and takes more commitment from you, then of course the Korg PA system is much better. The touchscreen, this is after all the selling point of this keyboard. This has been a big upgrade for the PSR S series, although the Korg PA series has had touchscreen for almost a decade, but finally Yamaha has kind of closed the gap and we have a touchscreen here. I can tell you that the touchscreen is good quality. They didn't cop out on you and you are getting your value for your money. The touchscreen is responsive and the layout is also very intuitive. So anyone who has been playing the previous S-series will feel right at home with just a couple of hours of familiarization. The one-touch setting on the PSR-SX series is very well programmed, and I would say that out of the box, the one-touch setting allows you to just call out a style and have four sets of registration just match for the styles perfectly. The volume as well as the effects are all just very well balanced, and you can start playing straight away without doing much work to it. Which compares to the Kork, I think the Kork PA series, the one-touch setting is not as well programmed as the one found on the PSR-SX series. The next feature I really like, and I think Yamaha has done very well this time, is the way the mixer panel is laid out. It is just so intuitive. Every effect that you will need when you're playing live, as well as the sliders, the panning, literally on-off switches for the channels, for the instruments, they are all found right here on this mixer panel. This is one of the best implementation of a mixer panel I have seen in a synth workstation or even an arranger keyboard for a very long time. The next feature I am enjoying for the first time on the PSR-SX range is the playlist feature. So on Kork PA series, we have the songbook function, which has been around for more than a decade on the Kork series keyboard. And this is really useful if you're trying to pull all your favorite pieces or the pieces that you will be playing in your gigs for a particular set all at one place. So this playlist is a very good step in the right direction and has been missing for the longest time, especially in an arranger where it is used very much in a live playing scenario. And finally, we have a file search facility. This is a problem that performers with hundreds or even thousands of songs face. You're trying to look for a particular song, but you don't want to swim through your entire database of a few hundred or even a few thousand songs. So the file search capabilities allow you to hunt down that particular song that you're looking for. However, it is not as granular in its search parameters as that found on the Kork PA series, but this is a good start anyway. The 10th thing I love about the PSR-SX series is we finally get a QWERTY input keyboard. You can really imagine the difficulty a lot of my students have trying to adapt to the old way of keying. You know, that's just reminiscence of the Nokia phones that we had like 8-10 years ago. Finally, we have something which is intuitive, the same keyboard that we find on our mobile phones and on our computer keyboard. The layout is very much similar, and this is one of those things that is just such a useful feature. Let's talk about the style creator feature on this keyboard. So one of the selling points of the PSR-SX series versus the PSR-E series, which is more of a learner's keyboard, is the ability to build your own styles from scratch. However, not everyone has the ambition to immediately create their own styles from scratch. So a new tweak to the style creator allows you to assemble different parts, different tracks, from various different styles into a brand new style. The 12th thing I love about this PSR-SX700 is that the new audio player loads a lot quicker, the layout is a lot more intuitive, all the features that you will need to manipulate that audio file, whether is it your time stretch or your audio cancel, all these features is right here within reach on the same menu. I have left the things I don't really like about this keyboard to the second part of this video on purpose. A lot of my viewers and subscribers, some of them think that I am being overly unfair to the PSR-SX and feel that I'm bashing it against Korg, I don't think you are getting the right impression. I am not sponsored. I give an unbiased view. And here are the things I don't really like about the PSR-SX series. The first thing is the metronome button is now missing. This is one of the features I use a lot. Whether you're trying to learn a new song, or you're trying to program a new style, or you're trying to just get into the groove of things, it is no longer a dedicated button, but is now an assignable button feature. Something I don't really see the sense of, since it is something I use and a lot of my students and other performers I know use the metronome very, very much when they are off stage. While the screen is a good step forward, there are a couple of things I am not too hot about, and I hope that a new firmware in future can basically just sort out this little niggles in the touchscreen. One of the things of the touchscreen is that from my viewing angle, and I'm a pretty tall person and I cannot imagine if somebody else were to be shorter, they would have even more problems, is that from my angle, it actually looked washed out. It should have been tilted towards the player more. So if I were to look over it, it just looks beautiful and the colors are vibrant, but from my direction, it just looks washed out, and under certain lighting condition, it can be quite hard to read as well. And this bezel, this is something that I don't understand. So this bezel actually blocks a lower portion of the screen from this angle that I'm using this keyboard, and it actually blocks out an important information that you may need. The critical function on the last bottom row is not visible from a seated position like this. The third thing I don't really like about the new assignable buttons, I love the assignable buttons, yes, but it can be better because I have no idea what these assignable buttons are until I go into the function and see what has been assigned to these buttons. Because this can be configured differently for every single registration, there's no way to remember what are the six functions you have assigned to these assignable buttons. So the screen has a lot of space. Yamaha actually has photos of the instrument that is selected. For aesthetics, it looks good, of course, but it is not very functional. I wish that they would have removed the photos and instead given us a row of icons or some words to tell us what features has been assigned to these assignable buttons, which I cannot see immediately from the homepage itself. The USB to device slot should have been placed right where the player is, right in front of me. And this is the position where players would be slotting in and out their flash drive rather than stretching out and trying to fumble where the actual connection is on the back. And guess what? There is still no USB audio out. So this has been something which the Genos players has been complaining about. The Genos guys, they paid like $5,000 for their instrument, whereas a $300 PSR E-series instrument has a USB audio interface. The PSR-SX series is literally a rompler. It is a sample-based keyboard, and I would think that moving forward, there would be an opportunity to put in a synthesis engine inside, an FM synthesis engine inside, where we can create sounds and synthesize sounds from scratch. However, at this price, I'm just really disappointed that we don't get a single synth engine within here. The voice editing feature on the PSR-SX is still some way behind that of the Korg PA series. So you can apply effects and you can just do a bit of voice adjustment, but you cannot significantly alter the voices, unlike what you can do on the more powerful Korg PA series. On a $2,000 keyboard, why is there no aftertouch? Seriously, Yamaha, what are you holding back your technology for? Even $200 MIDI controllers has aftertouch, and the Korg PA series has had aftertouch for like literally the longest time around this price range. And I think going forward in 2020, aftertouch should be a standard item on keyboards of this kind of price range. There should be no excuse. In fact, Yamaha has their higher range, the FSV keyboard, which has a horizontal touch, and that is found on the Yamaha Stager Electones And I love playing on that because if you're doing pitch bend, you don't have to take your hands off and control the pitch bend controller. You can bend your notes just by shifting the keys left or right. Why is there still no MIDI to styles converter? There are a lot of MIDI files out there which makes for very good styles. And if we can just load it in here and convert it into a style, it may not be perfect, but it is something to start with, and then the user can just edit and make the styles more tailored towards the SX series. The bad news is registrations are not really backward compatible. So if you were to take your registrations that you have accumulated over the years from the PSR-S series and you try to put it in here, it doesn't do that voice matching for you that very well. It doesn't sound as good as it should. There is a lot of user work to be done to tweak it, to have it sound good. Of course, if you have a couple of banks of registration, that is easy work. But with some of my students who have literally few hundred songs that they have to bring into this brand new instrument and try to retweak and revoice, it is just a lot of work. One of the things that I like in the PSR-S series is that when you select a super articulation voice, you go to the voice info. It will tell you what are the super articulation that is attached to that voice. However, there's no way to find out in this model. You have to guess, or if you are already previously familiar with it in the older models. Otherwise, you actually have to really go and try out and see what are the super articulation features that's attached to that super articulation voice. If you are not going to use the arranger functions of this keyboard, there is really no reason for you to get this keyboard. You are better off buying a Korg Chrome or, for example, a Yamaha Modi-X, which is a lot better for the sounds and the sounds editing as well as the synthesis of new sounds. And if you intend to connect this to a DAW and do most of your work in a computer, you'll be doing music production and less of live playing, I think you're better off getting a good MIDI controller and connecting it to your computer rather than buying an arranger like this and hoping that it will be a good MIDI controller, because there just simply isn't enough sliders and knobs, and the MIDI implementation is just not as good as a MIDI controller. And my third conclusion is this: the Tyros 4 and Tyros 5 sounds better than this, bar none, and because it has aftertouch. So if you can find a used Tyros 4 or Tyros 5 at a price similar to this PSR-SX700 or SX900 and it is in good condition, I would recommend that you go for the Tyros 4 or 5 rather than the PSR-SX700 or PSR-SX900.